Our second reading today is from the book of Mark. Mark 10:46-52. Then they came to Jericho. As Jesus and his disciples, together with a large crowd, were leaving the city, a blind man, which means son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside begging. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." Many rebuked him and told him to be quiet, but he shouted all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called to the blind man, "Cheer up, on your feet, he's calling you." Throwing his cloak aside, he jumped to his feet and came to Jesus. "What do you want me to do for you?" Jesus asked him. The blind man said, "Rabbi, I want to see." "Go," said Jesus, "your faith has healed you." Immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus along the road. Thanks be to God. Yeah, word of the God. Sorry. I'll get better.
Good job. My brother and his wife used to, I guess they still do, go to one of those mega churches down in Florida. Big, big place, you know, where they have thousands of people that come on a weekend to worship there. And so some years ago, and it's coming up close to 11 years ago, they had a little baby boy. And the first Sunday that they went and took the little guy to church, they were out in the grand entryway there in the church. And it happened that the senior pastor came walking through, and he stopped and he saw the baby, and he just made a comment about the baby, and like, "Oh, doesn't God do good work," or something like that. And my brother was just so excited. He said, "Oh, the senior pastor, he spoke to us." You know, I know you all do that too, but he was just really excited, and it's like, wow, you know, we just love it when somebody that we think is a celebrity or somebody who's important condescends to notice us or to speak to us. And, you know, we're just a nobody there, and he spoke to us. You know, Bartimaeus here, as he's sitting along the side of the road, he's kind of a nobody. We don't know much about him at all, except for what it says here in the scripture in this little passage. And we don't even really know his name. He's just called son of Timaeus, Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus. So it's his father's name. What's his real name? We don't really know. But he's just a nobody. He's sitting in this place where probably he has sat for who knows how long, maybe years, that he sat in that same place just begging. He's blind, so he has to get his living through charity, asking people. And so there he sits in a roadway in a popular spot. He hears the crowd going by, and he said, "Oh well, maybe he's going to get something here because there's a good amount of people." But somebody told him, they said, "Well, it's Jesus of Nazareth who's passing by." Well, oddly enough, he knows that. He doesn't say, "Who's that? Who are you talking about?" He knows who Jesus is. And in fact, so I think he must have somehow, he's heard about Jesus, maybe because he's been in that street and byway, that he's heard about the things that Jesus has done. And he's heard that Jesus can heal the sick and such. Maybe he's heard about these miraculous healings. But somehow, through his thinking about it, learning about Jesus, trying to hear about who this person is, somehow he's come to faith, to where he believes that this Jesus is in fact the Messiah. Because when he cries out, he calls him, he's Jesus, son of David. Well, that's a messianic term, to call him son of David. And so that was a profession of faith. He's saying, "I'm Jesus, Messiah. Jesus, you are the Messiah. You are the one that is supposed to come." And so he's, "Have mercy on me." You know, the people are kind of trying to hush him up for a little bit, but he cries all the louder, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." And so Jesus, it's like he stops. He takes notice of this man. He says, "Call him, let him come." And so the same people who probably were trying to hush him a minute ago, says, hey, cheer up. Good news, he's calling for you. He wants to talk to you. You know, this is great news that God is stopping to take time to have an audience with this one. You know, I don't know what all these people were thinking, but it's like, go, hurry. He wants to talk to you. You've got an audience with the king here. This is important. You know, sometimes I wonder if, as we think about our evangelism efforts, we're always like, well, how are we going to tell somebody about Jesus or whatever? Sometimes I think, can we just be these cheerleaders or the ones that are helping people say, yeah, God knows you. He's calling you. He wants to have a relationship with you. Come on, hurry, respond to the Lord. He's calling your name. Because I truly believe that God calls to every single person, that he wants everyone to be saved. And the Bible says that God is not willing that any should perish. He wants all people to come to him. And so I believe that God talks to every single person, that he gives them an opportunity to come, calls them by name. He knows every single person. He loves every single person. And I think he comes in different ways for different ones. But he's there. And so for Bartimaeus, he had to make that response. He had to say yes. And we know there's a lot of folks, maybe people that we know who haven't profess faith in Christ. There's a lot of folks in the world who think that, you know, their sins are just too awful. Oh, they couldn't possibly. God would never want anything to do with them. A lot of people in the world who have difficulty loving themselves, let alone thinking that anybody else could possibly love them, especially God. You know, if we can tell them and say, oh, God wants to have a relationship with you. God does love you. He calls your name. He knows you by name. He wants to be with you. How can we help people to hear that calling and to respond? Because it's not enough just to hear the call. We have to respond in faith. Bartimaeus responded. He had faith that Jesus is the Messiah. He must have believed that Jesus had power to heal because he calls him, Son of David, have mercy on me. So then Jesus, he goes there and he says, what do you want me to do for you? What do you want me to do for you? It's like, well, you might recall this is the same question Jesus had asked last week. You know, last week we read in Mark chapter 10, that previous passage where James and John, his two disciples, had come up and said, you know, we want you to do for us whatever we ask. And Jesus, well, what do you want me to do for you? Of course, with James and John, they were seeking glory for themselves. Let us sit one on your right and one on your left in your glory. Jesus is like, sorry, that decision has already been made. I can't change that. And so, they were seeking glory for themselves. And Jesus reminded them, he said, no, if you want to be great, you've got to be a servant. You have to be willing to serve the greatest. He said, the Son of Man didn't come to be served, but to serve, to give his life as a ransom for many. So now we see him here in front of Bartimaeus. And he asked him, what do you want me to do for you? It's like, he's the Lord. He's the King of glory. And he says, but how can I serve you? What can I do to be of service to you? What do you need? Bring it to me. And Bartimaeus just, I just want to see. I want my sight. Now we might say, well, isn't that a selfish thing too? He's just asking for something for himself. But, you know, I mean, James and John, they were seeking glory for themselves. Bartimaeus, he just wants to be healed so he can be like everybody else, to be a normal person and not have to beg for a living. Maybe he can go out and make his own way and, you know, take care of his own needs. Maybe work for the kingdom of God and help in whatever ways to be more able to do what he needs to do. And Jesus, go. Your faith has made you well. Your faith has healed you. See, he had faith that Jesus could do this. He trusted in Christ, that Christ is the Son of God, he is the Messiah, and that he could do this. Now we always know we need to be cautious and not go and say, okay, well then Jesus says, your faith has healed you. That so then the person that wants healing and prays to the Lord, but they don't receive healing, then, you know, the temptation there is to say, oh, well, then they clearly didn't have faith for healing. And sometimes that happens. You see that in the world today. Sometimes folks say, oh, well, it's their own fault. They must have sin, or they're not really believing, they're not having trusting in Jesus enough because they didn't get their healing, so clearly they're still a sinner. You know, it's like, no, we don't go there. It isn't that, because faith, healing kind of faith is a faith that trusts in God completely, where we know that God is able. Jesus is the Son of God. He is the Messiah, and he is able to heal, but we trust that God always knows what is best for us. And sometimes, maybe physical healing might not be what God has in store for this person. It might not be the best thing, but God always, always brings healing. Every heart, every person that comes to Christ with their heart open, ready to receive, receives and is healed. We know, of course, I mean, our greatest healing that we have received in our lives is when we trusted Christ, when we were born again into God's family. We were sinners, lost and alone. But when we came to Christ, we received that healing. That's the greatest miracle of all, to be born again into God's family, to receive our salvation. So every person that comes to Christ receives that. No one gets turned away. No one is told they're too lowly or too unimportant, too out there. God's love is for all. And so he reaches, he calls to every person, offering them that chance to come and receive. But we've got to respond by faith. I think we can do our homework like, you know, Bartimaeus listened, he studied on it a little bit. He had to learn ahead of time, who is this Jesus? You know, our faith is not a blind faith. I hate to use the word blind when we're talking about Bartimaeus, but you know, ours is not a blind faith. We believe in true facts that this actually happened, that Jesus Christ came as God in the flesh, that he died on the cross, he rose again bodily from the grave. These are historical facts. And so our faith is something we can study. We can test that and look into that, read the scripture, study it for ourselves, look through it, because and ask questions, dig in. If you've got questions, ask and study on it, because if it's true, then we ought to be able to really tear it apart and look and find in there. God's not, doesn't have anything to hide. He's like, oh no, don't look there. Oh, no, study on it. I think Bartimaeus looked into this. He examined, who is this Jesus? And then he came to faith. We have to respond by faith. The offer is out for everybody. But it's ours. It becomes ours when we respond by faith. Having that faith that God is able, Jesus Christ is the Messiah, he's the Son of God, and he is able, and we trust that God knows what is best in every situation. It may not be exactly what we're asking for. James and John, they heard no. When Jesus said, well, they asked him for something and said, no, that's not going to necessarily happen. But when we come to Christ by faith, every person receives healing in their heart, in their spirit. Every person, without exception, when they come to Christ. And so I wonder this morning, you know, what is it that you would cry out to Jesus this morning for? Jesus says, you know, what do you want me to do for you? What is it you need this morning in your own life, in your own walk with Christ? For some, you know, maybe it is a physical healing that you need. For some, maybe it's a financial issue. Is there a relationship issue, or children that have gone off in a wrong direction, or whatever it is? Are you just feeling, I just need to grow in my faith? I'm struggling with a particular area. Jesus asks you this morning, you know, what do you want me to do for you? He's ready to serve you as well. Bring it to the Lord. Trust and believe that he is the Lord. He is the powerful one. He is the creator. And he knows what is best. And he will make it right for you. He will do whatever is best. It might not be exactly what you're asking for, but it would be something better. So bring it to the Lord this morning. Father, I thank you that you've given to us the gift of faith. For indeed, we cannot even take credit. We cannot claim that we are any better than anyone else, that we have faith. Because our faith is a gift from you. So Lord, help us this morning to have more faith, to trust, to believe that you are at work in our lives. You are aware of those broken places, those difficult spots. But we offer them before you. You say, what do you want me to do for you? Lord, that we might receive our sight to see how you are at work in this world. We look around and sometimes it's just a challenge. We don't understand what's going on. Lord, that we might see with your eyes to be at work in the world where you are at work. Grant us your peace, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.